The graph editor is simply a representation of keyframe property values of the timeline displayed in a two-dimensional graph in which we can manipulate the speed and duration of keyframe anchor points. To access the graph editor, click on the graph editor button in the timeline panel or press Shift F3 on the keyboard. Now, to see the keyframes inside the graph editor, I will first press the letter U on the keyboard to reveal the keyframe properties of the circle layer, and then click on the scale property value. So what we have here is a simple linear animation with three keyframes. On the first one, the circle is at 70% scale down. On the second keyframe, the circle is at 140% scaled up, and then back at 70% on the third keyframe. To select the keyframe, just click on it with the selection tool. We can move that keyframe around. We can also hold the Shift key to constrain the movement and snap it along the vertical axis. We can double click and bring up the scale window and set a specific value. Let's say I'm going to set both the width and the height to 200%. We can also click on the chain icon to unconstrain each of these values, and by scrubbing the width and height separately, we can create an oval shape. We can also select multiple keyframes by Shift Select or Marquee Select with the selection tool, which is indicated by a semi-opaque white box with handles around the selected frames. We can drag those frames around. In this case, I'm moving the keyframe to frame 20, which is reflected when we switch to the layer bar mode by clicking on the graph editor icon. We can move those keyframes down, which means the scale property has changed from 140% to something like 120. Again, this is reflected when we switch to the layer bar mode and looking at the scale property of that keyframe. With multiple keyframes selected, we can scale values around the center of the anchor point by holding the Control key or the Command key on the keyboard and drag the corner of the bounding box. We can also press and hold the Alt or Option key on the keyboard to move a handle of the bounding box independently of the other handles. To taper keyframe values proportionally, we can press and hold the Ctrl-Alt or Command-Option and drag on the corner of the transform box, which will allow us to reduce or expand the amplitude of a repeated animation. So let us go ahead and explore what all these option buttons mean inside the graph editor. The first option button specifies which properties are shown in the graph editor, with the Show Selected Properties being the most widely used. The next option is the graph options in the graph editor. Usually, you will be working with either the value graph or the speed graph. The rest are different options in what you want to view within the graph, whether these are audio waveforms, in and out points, or what have you. With the Show Transform box, when selected keys are selected, I will marquee select those two keyframes, and when I toggle that off, we can still see keyframes, move them around, just without the semi-opaque white transform box. The next one is the Snap option button. When you drag a keyframe inside the graph editor with a snap selected, the keyframe snaps to keyframe values, in and out points, markers, and so on. The Auto Zoom Height mode automatically scales the height of the graph, so it fits the height of the graph editor. So if, for example, when I double-click on this keyframe and set it to 100% with the Auto Zoom Height on, After Effects scales the height of the graph to the new property value. If we toggle that off and move the keyframe, nothing will change. The Fit Selection to View will scale the graph to fit the selected keyframes inside the graph editor. So when our marquee selects those two keyframes, only those will be visible. To see all keyframes again, just click on the next option, the Fit All Graphs to View. All right, now I'm going to switch to the second layer, the Separate Dimensions layer, which has no keyframes set to it. In this case, I will first convert the layer into a 3D layer by clicking on the cube icon and then click on the position property to set the first keyframe by clicking on the stopwatch. I will move the current time indicator to frame 1 and set another keyframe by clicking on the add remove keyframe icon. I will switch to the graph editor and click on the separate dimensions button at the bottom of the options bar. That separates components of the position property into individual properties for the X position, the Y position, and the Z position, so we can modify or animate each of these values independently. In After Effects, interpolation refers to how it calculates the speed and time values between two keyframes. So there are different type of keyframes inside After Effects. So we will start with the linear interpolation, which creates a uniform rate of change between keyframes. It begins instantly at the first keyframe and continues to the next one at a constant speed and velocity. In the graph editor, the segment connecting two keyframes with the linear interpolation appears as a straight line. For the next type of keyframe, I will select the first one inside the graph editor and use the hold keyframe, which changes the value of a layer property over time, but without a gradual transition. So in this case, the first keyframe holds steady until the next one, when the value changes immediately. In the graph editor, the graph segment following a hold keyframe appears as a horizontal straight line. For the next keyframe type, I will select all visible keyframes. In this case, I will use the keyboard shortcuts and apply the auto Bezier interpolation, which creates a smooth transition between keyframes. Notice the directional handles coming out of each keyframe, which means we can edit the curve by clicking, dragging, and perhaps holding the Shift key as we do, and pulling the handle away from the keyframe, which will influence the amount of time it takes for the animation to take off. The same can be applied on this curve by pulling and dragging the control handle away from this keyframe, so the whole animation starts slow, it speeds up, and slows down at the end. So I'm going to select all keyframes and set them back to linear interpolation. The next keyframe type refers to Easy Ease, which is a combination of Ease In and Ease Out, and it's used when elements need to be accelerated and decelerated. Now let us go ahead and look at the difference between Auto Bezier and Easy Ease. With the Auto Bezier interpolation, the curve is not as smooth, and the directional handles are shorter. With Easy Ease interpolation, the directional handles are quite stretched out from the keyframes, making the acceleration and deceleration much more noticeable. All right, let us go ahead and set all keyframes back to linear interpolation and talk about the next two type of keyframes. The first one refers to Ease In, which is used at any frame that needs to be decelerated or stopped. In this case, the first keyframe speeds up and slows down at the end. The opposite happens with the next keyframe type, referring to Ease Out, which is used at frames that need to be accelerated. So in this case, the animation starts slow and then speeds up towards the end. Another thing we can do inside the graph editor is we can select a keyframe, right-click on it, and we are presented with a pop-up window. Here, for example, we can change the interpolation to hold keyframes, or we can use the keyframe assistant to choose from different types of keyframes. Thank you everyone for visiting my channel and watching the inspired lectures and tutorials. Do not forget to subscribe and share the knowledge.